Hey everybody, it's AK Family Home here, and today we're going to be talking about the Joy-Con, Nintendo's virtual ice cube simulators that Nintendo's new controllers for the Switch that, as they say, give you total gameplay flexibility. You can swing them around with motion controls like baby Wii remotes, hold them separately and play while lying in bed, give it to another player and then watch as they keep taking accidental screenshots with the capture button, or slot them into the Joy-Con grip, making it become a more traditional controller. But is it really that traditional considering Nintendo has also released a dedicated Pro controller for the Switch that at first glance does the exact same thing that the bundled Joy-Con grip can already accomplish? Well, not exactly, as there are definitely significant differences between the two, so without further ado, let's begin comparing their pros and cons. Thank you, have a great night. Keep in mind, I'm not taking the Joy-Con's functionality when held separately or sideways into account, as I'm simply pitting the Joy-Con grip layout against the Pro Controller so that people who aren't sure if they should stick to the Joy-Con grip can learn more about the differences that the Pro Controller offers. Let's just get the similarities out of the way first. Both the Joy-Con grip and Pro Controller offer the same buttons. Analog sticks, directional buttons, A, B, X, Y, plus, minus, L, Z, R, L, R, the capture button and the home button, as well as HD Rumble and Amiibo functionality. The only differences here are how some of the buttons are laid out and the presence of the sandwich eating sensor on the right Joy-Con. Okay, you probably already know the obvious differences between the two, so I don't really have to explain how the plus and minus buttons are shaped differently or something like that. Let's just get to the nitty gritty. First of all, the Pro Controller definitely has a better button placement than the Joy-Con grip, as it is designed as a traditional controller itself. With how the Joy-Cons have to be completely vertical, the button placement on the Joy-Con grip might feel off-putting to some if they're accustomed to a traditional controller. For me, however, I can use it just fine as a normal controller, the only nitpick being how the right stick might get in the way when I try to access both the Y and B buttons. Onto the buttons themselves, they are much larger on the Pro Controller, so you might want to take that into consideration if you have large hands, and the buttons are slightly less clicky than those of the Joy-Con. At first I was a bit worried, seeing I didn't like the mushy buttons on the DS Lite and original 2DS, but they are less mushy here and the larger buttons allow me to get a better grip on the buttons themselves. The D-pad on the Pro Controller obviously replaces the directional buttons on the Joy-Con and works really well. I've seen some reports about it not registering directions accurately for some people, like registering left and right as up instead, but so far I've had no issues with it. It's definitely better than the independent buttons on the Joy-Con if you want to play 2D games, but personally I don't find moving in 2D games that big of a problem on the Joy-Con because, cue amazingly timed segue into the analog sticks. Now these are probably, in my opinion, one of the biggest differences between the Pro Controller and Joy-Con grip. On the Joy-Con grip, due to the need for being portable, the analog stick is pretty tiny and only travels a short distance. While it might not be ideal for actual analog movement, it works pretty dang fine in and of itself, and it's even pretty great for 2D movement in side-scrollers, as snapping from one direction to the opposite is very quick, just like using an actual D-pad. Compared to other options like the directional buttons or the 3DS's circle pad, I think that this is the best analog stick for covering both 3D and 2D movement. On the Pro Controller, the analog stick travel is larger and similar to other traditional controllers, so it's not as good for 2D movement, although that's what the D-pad is for.
Hey yo, I'm just adding this extra bit in here to showcase one of the actual minor issues I've been having with the Switch Pro Controller. And that is when you flick any of the analog sticks in one direction, sometimes it registers the opposite direction when it goes back to the original position. For example, if I try to flick this analog stick right, you see sometimes the dot on the screen sometimes goes to the left side instead. And same, for example, if I flick downwards, it sometimes goes back up. And it's not that big of a deal, like if I hold it and release it, it doesn't do that, but when I'm quickly scrolling through menus by flicking the analog stick, sometimes it goes back to a previous option. So it is kind of annoying, and I'm not sure if my controller is the only one that does this, so leave your comments below. I'm curious to see if anyone else is experiencing this problem. So yeah, that's the only problem I have with it, honestly.
Oh, and let's not forget the shoulder buttons, which are definitely larger and more comfortable on the Pro Controller, especially with the L and R buttons, which are basically just fin strips on the Joy-Con grip. As a side note, I also wanted to mention that even though HD Rumble is present on both the Joy-Con Grip and Pro Controller, I feel that the effect is definitely much more stronger and noticeable in the Joy-Con Grip, probably because there are two Rumble engines in that configuration instead of one. As such, Rumble effects like the engine revving in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe feel much more enhanced. Last but not least, the battery life. The Joy-Con have an estimated battery life of about 20 hours each, and to charge them you either have to buy the charging grip or battery pack sold separately, or attach them to the Switch itself while it's charging. The battery life is totally adequate, but let's be honest here, who wants to keep track of two separate battery meters, am I right? There is that slight possibility that one might run out of juice before the other after all. And enter the Pro Controller, with a staggering estimated battery life of 40 hours, thanks to it containing basically a 3DS battery. If you're using it normally, you could probably be able to use it for a month or more after a single charge. That's very impressive, and both the charging Joy-Con Grip and Pro Controller charge via USB-C, which is the cherry on top of the sundae. So, what's the final verdict? Well, it goes without saying that if you're going to be playing the Switch in docked mode a lot, the Pro Controller is obviously going to be the better choice with its great ergonomics, large buttons, and the like. But to other people, is it worth the $70 asking price when they already have the Joy-Con Grip? Personally, I don't find the Joy-Con Grip that bad if you just want something that sort of resembles a traditional controller. Heck, I only got the Pro Controller a few days ago and was perfectly fine with or without it. But if you're one of those serious pro players who play for longer times, the bonuses offered by the Pro Controller are definitely worth it. And to be honest, a lot of it really comes down to personal preference. Some people might like to click your buttons on the Joy-Con, some might prefer larger analog stick travel, etc. So in the end, it's really up to you to decide which one is more suited for you based on the small differences I mentioned and your regular playstyle. Well, that's about it for this video. I hope this can help anyone who's currently on the fence about upgrading controllers, and I'll catch you guys later when my next major video is complete. MVBBY!